My name is Connor Johnson. I'm a medical oncologist at the Center for Lymphoma and Massachusetts General Hospital's Cancer Center. And it's my privilege today to talk about the Polarix trial, which is potentially changing the standard of care for the treatment of diffuse large B-cell lymphoma, the most common lymphoma.
The key takeaways for this talk are to review the current standard of care for diffuse large B-cell lymphoma, and to recognize the significance of the Polarix trial to our understanding of the evolving treatment of diffuse large B-cell lymphoma.
What's the prior standard of care for upfront treatment of diffuse large B-cell lymphoma? This is a slide showing, in a large clinical trial called the Goya trial, the outcomes with standard of care RCHOP. RCHOP refers to rituximab, an antibody to CD20, a protein on the outside of diffuse large B-cell lymphoma that is expressed, as well as a combination of prednisone, an oral corticosteroid, and three chemotherapy drugs named cyclophosphamide, adriamycin, and vincristine. This combination regimen has been the standard for over two decades, and this progression-free survival curve shows a cure rate of about 67%, or two-thirds of patients. A number of different clinical trials have been conducted to try and improve upon this without success to date. Polatuzumab vedotin is a relatively new drug in our armamentarium for diffuse large B-cell lymphoma. It's actually an antibody-drug conjugate to the protein CD79B, and it's conjugated to MMAE, or chemotherapy. It binds to CD79B, and then is internalized into cells. The FDA has actually already approved this drug in combination with bendamustine, a chemotherapeutic, and rituximab, the previously mentioned CD20 antibody, for the treatment of diffuse large B-cell lymphoma when it's relapsed or refractory, so not in the frontline setting. So a natural question has emerged of where this drug might apply in terms of upfront treatment of diffuse large B-cell lymphoma. The Polarix trial sought to answer this question. It's a randomized trial comparing six full cycles of standard chemotherapy with RCHOP, with some additional treatments with rituximab, to a new regimen, which is RCHOP minus the vincristine, and instead substituting polatuzumab vedotin with the same treatment standard regimen of six cycles with two additional rituximab doses. The primary endpoint of this study is progression-free survival, an important endpoint in diffuse large B-cell lymphoma. Patients had to all have what's called untreated DLBCL with higher risk IPI scores of 2 or higher, and a good performance status in order to participate in the study. And there was stratification based on risk scores like the IPI that we mentioned before and the overall tumor size of disease. These are some key characteristics for the patients who enrolled in the study. In terms of the two arms, they were well matched and there were no differences that are notable in terms of the actual patient populations. I'll just note that these are patients that had advanced stage disease primarily, they're patients that had higher risk IPI scores, and they're patients that had a significant fraction of them at least with bulky disease, or defined as more than 7.5 centimeters in the longest diameter of disease. Here are the money slides for the actual trial itself to highlight the important outcomes. In box A, we see the progression-free survival curves comparing polatuzumab added to RCHP versus standard RCHOP. There's a 6.5% absolute difference in 2-year progression-free survival between these two arms in favor of polatuzumab. In the other box, we see the overall survival curves, which show no difference between the two arms. Importantly, toxicities were examined between the two regimens, and there's really no notable differences, with similar rates of adverse events, similar rates of grade 3 to 4 and grade 5 adverse events, and similar rates of overall discontinuation of study drugs. So what are the key takeaways from this new study in diffuse large B-cell lymphoma? This is really the first positive trial in upfront diffuse large B-cell lymphoma treatment in nearly two decades. So this is a remarkable addition to the overall knowledge base of diffuse large B-cell lymphoma. The overall benefit from progression-free survival is relatively modest, though, at 6.5% at 2 years, as an absolute difference in favor of the polatuzumab vedotin arm. How this emerges into the standard of care is currently being defined, and it remains to be seen. Thank you for watching. I hope this video has been educational.